This is WDSU News at 5.
Good evening, everyone. We begin with exclusive new details into a story that the I-Team broke 2 weeks ago.
Officers who make up a major drug task force are accused of stealing money from a suspected drug dealer. I-Team reporter Travers Mackey explains the new direction this case is taking.
This videotape that shows undercover narcotics officers from the West Bank Major Crimes Task Force entering and exiting the home of suspected drug dealer Stephen Daigle is now in the hands of the FBI.
And the FBI has agreed to look into this matter.
District Attorney Leon Canizero says the feds stepping in does not mean he's bowing out, just that there could be more scrutiny for the officers involved.
And just because the federal government is involved with an investigation, that does not necessarily mean that state charges cannot also be filed.
We first showed you the video 2 weeks ago, the day that Canizero's office dropped felony charges against Daigle. Documents obtained by the I-Team show that cops from the task force, which is made up of officers from New Orleans, JPSO, Plaquemines Parish Sheriff, and Gretna and West Wego Police, arrested Daigle at his Mid-City art studio last January. They confiscated drugs, and NOPD Detective Ray Veit says in the report that Daigle was transported to central lockup and booked. But the video shows two officers escort Daigle, uncuffed, into his French Quarter apartment. When they leave, one of the officers has something in his hand. Daigle's attorney says the cops took $3,500 in cash from the apartment. Documents show the officers never reported it anywhere.
Officers in the Joint Governmental Task Force here in New Orleans had targeted our client as a means to enrich themselves rather than actually fight any crime.
Legal analysts say federal involvement could spell trouble for the officers.
They can coordinate getting what? Information on these guys from NOPD, from Gretna and other jurisdictions, where if it was just NOPD doing it, they got a DA's office, then they got to go to a JP and other people to do it as well. So here they can bring it all together in the Eastern District and prosecute it as one.
It's really no timetable. I can't predict how long or how short their investigation will take.
Both the NOPD and Gretna Police Departments have launched internal probes into this matter. All officers involved are still on the job and working on this drug task force. Scott?
All right, Travers, thanks. The West Bank Major Crimes Task Force was formed after Hurricane Katrina. Since its inception, officers have made more than 700 arrests with a conviction rate of 89%. To see more of the exclusive video used in this story, go to our website, WDSU.com. And